In 1990, I invited 7 of the top calligraphic artists in New Mexico at the time to meet and dialogue about how we might learn from each other. We decided to go into retreat together twice a year. What began so simply evolved into a significant 25-year experiment in collaboration. For years, we worked on creating books together, always painstakingly making 8 of everything so we could each have a copy. We all reached deep inside when we created the book about our heroes, which we experienced as quite personal. And though we made the books over 10 years ago, most of us go there when thinking about one of the most powerful projects we've worked on together. Then we went 3D, each creating objects of different volumes designed to fit perfectly into an 8x8 cube, which included wood blocks, sandblasted stone, and porcelain facsimiles of bones inscribed with ancient scripts. We interpreted the word journey and put our ideas into matchboxes, decorated an 8-foot column with various numbers, formulas, and quotes about mathematics that moves around in the Albuquerque public schools to inspire students, worked in sequence on the same pieces while listening to Rhapsody in Blue, glazed pots and donated them to a fundraiser for a food bank, made a mural glazing tiles, working shoulder to shoulder for the kitchen of the member who hosts our retreats, collaborated on monotypes, performed a Paul Fleshman play together, put on an extensive exhibit of collaborative work in Silver City on the blues, and 2 others in Albuquerque. We visited the studios of artists, including those of Gail and Zach Reiki, and early on realized there were artists we wanted to study with, who we called Bridges to the Mainland. We learned oil pastels with the celebrated painter Carol Anthony, which was formative for several of us in our own work, and we wrote poems with Santa Fe's poet laureate Joan Logie. To learn more from Georgia O'Keeffe, we toured her home and studio in Abiquiu, drawing and painting in the spots where she painted. We traveled to Oaxaca to explore the arts and crafts of Mexico and studied fine cuisine with our favorite chef in New Mexico. This project involved 3 days of creating a vegetarian feast, which ranged from picking the vegetables and tasting local wines to creating oil pastels for each of 8 courses. For years, we also worked together on a book with book artist Suzanne Moore, focusing simply on the letter A. A book was a more extensive collaboration involving 8 of New Mexico's most well-known writers. The edition of 1,000 sold out immediately. Riding the wave of A book success, we were invited to exhibit and give the keynote presentation about collaboration at Sonoma State University for an international conference of 1,000 artists. But in 2013, we lost our beloved mentor and collaborator, Santa Fe living treasure Mary Lou Cook, at the age of 94. The iconic photo of her with a bandolier for bullets transformed into a holder for pens says it all. Scribes 8 lost some of its momentum, and the group was at risk of disbanding. We started talking about what this experience has meant to us.
There's a great tradition in arts and sciences and business and other kinds of things where people have come together to collaborate. And even the word itself, collabore, to work together, but it's working together in a way that really does express that principle that when 2 or more people work together on something, they can achieve things that neither one could accomplish on their own. And that's the genius of collaboration, is that allows you to do that. But what enables that, and I think what we've developed, I'm not sure we had it always from the start, but I think we got it very quickly, was this trust.
We care deeply, and we don't care. And when I think about that, to explain it a bit, I think we collaborate because we have learned to not care in the sense that we can let our egos go at times, and that someone can make a mark or cover up something that we've done and worked on, and it's okay.
Yeah, there's been 2 things in my life in terms of my artistic growth that have been pivotal, and being part of this group is one of them, and going to Ghost Ranch is another one. It's like I became an artist from those experiences, and I Yeah, feel incredibly blessed.
We've just been through so much personally and artistically. I mean, I can't say that any one of us is the same artist that we were when we first started. And so it's just been a fabulous experience. I wouldn't trade it for anything. It's one of the things I cherish most in my artistic career.
So this year, Scribes 8 experienced a kind of renaissance during a weekend together exploring encaustic techniques. We recommitted to going on a retreat together, and this long-lived and remarkable collaborative group now moves forward with heightened energy, this time towards new adventures and our 30th anniversary.